Hello, hello! Today I want to show you something really cool, how I turn my touch panel into a digital drawing board. But that's not all, because wherever I draw on it, I can see also this on the computer screen. Really cool, yeah? So, as you know from the previous video, Aircrow sent me their new 7-inch CrowPanel Advance display for testing. And honestly, the more I use this panel, the more I like it. In previous project, I transformed this panel into a digital photo frame. I went through the Arduino IDE setup process and shared how I configured everything and how it works. If you are just starting out with CrowPanel, or are simply curious how to get started, you can check out my latest blog post or YouTube video. So, as I mentioned earlier, today I want to talk about something more interactive. I thought I'd like to know more about how touchscreens works. It would be useful when I build my AI assistant. That's when I come up with the idea of turning it into a simple drawing screen. The plan was that when you touch it with your finger, a dot would appear, and when you drag it, a line would appear. At the same time, your fingers' coordinates will be continuously printed on the serial monitor. Simple? Yeah. Useful? Actually, very. Fun? For me, yes. Of course, only after everything started working. It wasn't just about drawing pictures. It was about getting to know your equipment. You learn this without even realizing it when you do similar projects. While the concept sounds simple, this mini project is a great crash course in understanding touch coordinates, X and Y, handling real-time screen refreshes and drawing, managing drawing logic between previous and current points, using the serial monitor for debugging and even identifying gestures, and building the foundation for much larger touch applications. Yes, it's just drawing, but it's also practical hardware education in this case. How does it work? Let me quickly explain. The tap screen detects when and where your finger touched the panel. This gives us the X and Y coordinates. If it's just a touch, the panel drops a point. If it's a swipe, it selects multiple points and draws a line. This creates a smooth drawing, not pixelated choppy points. Additionally, each coordinate is printed in the serial monitor, so you can literally see the data stream as you draw. This type of feedback is incredibly useful when you plan to build any interactive interface like menus, sliders, keyboards, or even mini games. You might ask, why do I need this? Touchscreen interfaces are everywhere these days. And building one yourself allows you to understand how it works. This project gives me more confidence. You can experiment further and create interesting things, for example, custom control panel for smart home automation, small virtual piano, password entry interface, simple touchscreen games, or just your own paint on the touchpad. However, I'm leaning towards an AI assistant. There is also something strangely satisfying about touching the screen and seeing response on the computer screen, especially when you build something like that yourself. If you're wondering what's under the hood, I wrote the code in the Arduino IDE using standard libraries like this found in the Electro projects. You don't need to any fancy AI or 3D engines here. Just clean responsive code and good understanding how to update pixels efficiently. And yes, serial output isn't just a gadget. It's very useful for debugging or touch tracking. Want to try it yourself? If you are curious, I have good news. I've shared the code on my blog and you can find the link in the description. So, sometimes the best way to learn is to do something for fun. Just like turning the CrowPanel screen into a sketchboard. It might seem simple, but such hands-on experiments teach you a lot about hardware, programming and interfacing logic. If you are curious about what's next, stay tuned. I have some interesting ideas about myself. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. By the way, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in the next video.